but we are checking out today, and we'll be heading towards Polyvetta, and the destination is Porcupine Castle. I have been researching about this resort for a long time now, and the hopes are really high. The resort is situated in a coffee plantation. Just can't wait to go there. Tonight we are going to stay there, and tomorrow we'll check out from there and head back to Bangalore. So Polyvetta is another village in Coorg. It is less popular than Madikeri, but it is very, very famous for coffee plantations. Plan is to pick up some spices, coffee, honey from Coorg today, particularly Polyvetta, because it is very, very good for picking up stuffs like this. We will have lunch on the way. I have been looking for Coorgi cuisine, but I'm not sure if I'll be able to find out something. So the option is either to go for Coorg cuisine for lunch, or to head to a beautiful cafe. This is the view from our room right now, and I am loving every part of it. This is a valley, the Madikeri valley, that is visible from the room today. And it is only possible when the clouds clear up. And today, before going, I think we've got this gift from nature to see its beauty in the fullest form. Hey guys, so we are on our way to Polyvetta, and we have stopped for a quick lunch. This is a cafe. It is called Pick Up Cafe, and it is one of the best cafes in Coorg. So wherever I go, I think food becomes a very important part of the journey, and I keep looking for the best places to eat, the best cafes around. I heard Coorg has some really good cafes, and I'm not at all disappointed coming here. The place is really pretty. You can see in the background. I'm seated here, and the food has just arrived. We've just ordered some munchies to start with. Chicken nuggets, fish finger, and coffee, local Kodagu coffee. And now we're going to have some pizzas and pasta. So the food is really good so far. And before the next set of items come in, I thought I'll take a tour of the property and also take you people along with me. We've reached Polyvetta, and we have checked into the Porcupine Castle, which is our second destination in this Coorg travel. So Coorg is a place wherein you would want to come again and again. This is my first visit to Coorg, but I'm sure I'll come again. It's one of the best places you can visit in India, and it is very near to where we stay. So for Bangaloreans, I think this is a very, very sought after destination. So this is the Porcupine Castle. You can see the view. This is a valley view again. So there is a plantation view room as well, and there is a valley view room and mountain view rooms available as well. So initially when we were booking, we were able to book only plantation view, but then once I reached, we kind of got an upgrade to a Valley View room. So the rooms are just getting a little clean because we changed the room. But we're just giving 10 minutes time for the rooms to get clean. In the meantime, I'm just exploring the property, and I think they have lots of activity. So there's a Jeep drive wherein they will take us to see the plantation. So this is a coffee plantation where this particular cottage is situated, and we will take that plantation tour tomorrow. Tonight there's a bonfire, they said. So the plan is to get a little freshen up in the room and come back and enjoy a little party by the bonfire. So just let's just see how beautiful the view is. This is Polibeta, which is a village in Coorg, and the name of the place where we are staying tonight is called the Porcupine Castle. It's in a very secluded location, but very beautiful, very scenic. So you can definitely consider this whenever you are planning a Coorg. This is the balcony. And here is the dining hall. And this is the area where probably they'll organize a bonfire today. Hello. Room. More interest in the view and the balcony. Yeah, this is the view. You can see a church there as well. Nice. Hey guys, good morning. Today is our last day at Coorg. We are at the Porcupine Castle and we are taking a tour of the property. The property is beautiful. I showed a glimpse of it yesterday as well. It is surrounded by coffee plantation everywhere. So after the short tour, the plan today is to have breakfast and then go for a plantation drive. They organized this Jeep tour for the plantation views. We're really loving the property because it is very unique. There's mountain view, there's a plantation view. So it's also eerie, honestly, because it is silent. It's such a huge property spread over acres of land that you hardly see faces of people. So yesterday night, I was very scared with the silence. But then this morning again, it is very peaceful. There's an awesome view from here, the whole of plantation, which right now is covered, totally covered in clouds. But we will have a tour of the property. I can show you how beautiful these cottages look, which are overseeing the plantation and the valley in front. And this is Polibeta, which is one of a very famous place known for Coorg coffees. So let's have a tour. Thank you. We're all waiting patiently. Oh, superb. Come for breakfast. As you can see, this is the view. I think tomorrow morning again we'll be back to the city life. We'll be back to the usual routine. So this is the last breakfast amidst this beautiful view for this trip, at least. Is coffee plantation, valleys, mountains, everything visible from here. This is actually the dining place. Fastest one, but while going we wanted to drive down through the Nagarhole National Park. We know that that's a very scenic route and we get to pass the national park, so we're taking that route. Via that route we'll reach Bangalore. Timing is more or less same, half an hour here and there, right? Okay. Half an hour, 1 hour here and there. So we are going towards Nagarhole National Park first and then we will drive from there to our home, which is back to Bangalore after the last 3 days of a wonderful trip.